Onivia, League of Legends highlights.
Boost. No, he's playing Ornn. Okay, there we go. That makes a lot more sense. And
Diana mid?
This also makes it more likely that Diana's going into a lane.
Yeah, Diana mid, I think, going to be up against the Aurelion.
Oh, here we go. Again, a bit aggressive this time. This is what the change does. It allows you a lot more mobility and potential engage options.
Just not enough, unfortunately. As Kingan's going to look for a really aggressive trade here. Game plan here is we're going to see a big fight over this red.
Yeah, everybody's getting in here, and June is spotted, but they still want to get in here. Barrel just runs straight into the combo, as that is a nice call of the Forge God. They're going to be able to kill this Aurelia. Barrel tanked up so much of the damage early on, and now he's going back in. As flashes over the wall will come in, and look at that pillar! That is so annoying to deal with, as a huge amount of damage does come out from Pyoshik, but he's getting himself into danger as he's not able to pick up that kill.
Oh, so indecisive here as Pyoshik, he easily gets out.
They haven't gotten any plates just yet, so there's that, as okay, we're just running straight into the Ornn, not sure about that. Now trying to turn this one around as they're trying to get over to Kingan. But they're not sure about this one, and they're just going to let Jett die. With Barrel and Canyon coming down the river, they say, well, we might as well not get in there as well. That was an interesting ultimate from Canyon.
A lot slower, you know, playing the Mundo. I'm going to try to play a very slow
game.
He's
going for this. The Vanguard Jett is in, and Khan is in a lot of trouble here. He's trying to get some kind of knockup, but he doesn't have the cooldown, and Kingan will pick up the solo kill.
He's going to get that kill. It's going to be the Rift Herald dropped in mid. Meanwhile, and this should actually be dealt with, you know, decently. It's going to get its charge off, but that's all it's going to be. The wave gets cleared.
Yeah.
But these are two completely different styles of draft for DRX, and you can see why they're reluctant to draft like this in game one, because Damwon Kia are just so good at skirmishing. And every time it looks like you have positional advantage or you have a comp that's stronger, Damwon Kia outdo you. And yes, Khan does die, so there's an opportunity.
Oh, nice one onto the Diana, but they're not able to kill him. And Canyon gets over the wall.
Ghost.
It's so unfortunate for him as Pyoshik's just putting him down a wall to try to survive, but it's not gonna happen.
Canyon's just going straight back to doing camps.
Fortunately for DRX, they've tried to make Renekton and Taliyah work a bunch, but it has not been able to work too much as the Aurelia will be able to get into some of that defensive mode, but it's not going to be enough. 2-on-1. And the damage coming out from Canyon is just a bit too much at this point in time. So
want to have with these champions in isolation, but do they work well together later on in the game in those team fights? That's the question. Might not matter if they get enough of a lead now.
Yeah, just not even identifying where he's at on the map here as he flashes and dies to the rocket belt aforementioned.
And that's
casually 3-0. And let's see it. Are you going to make a play up on the top side?
He has flash. He's just going to get out of here. Just respecting this, knowing the bottom side of the map is going to get a full turret here in return because Taeyun is alone. And there's a ping instantly, by the way, onto the Tom Kench by DRX. I think there's some comms issues right now. Like, why aren't you doing anything, unfortunately, June? Because you're not doing anything but holding this mid wave that I don't really need you to hold. You're not actually allowing
to be alongside of the Diana. Fantastic for setting up picks here as they're trying to make this Taliyah Renekton thing work.
Once again, a bait.
Yeah, he's on the ground and down he goes. Does the croc once again, unfortunately for him. June playing Tom Kench, he's fine. He hasn't died yet.
Every time you think you have an opportunity as DRX, you should just trust that you don't. Because
well,
it's just been every single time they try to look for these types of plays, it's backfired. I mean, across two games now.
Arrow got the arrow, and here we go. But the cleanse is there, and Ghost is just hopping along the wall. Doesn't seem to care. The Fate's Call is here as well as the sun comes in. The Aurelia trying to do something on the backside, but the second that Kingan goes down, this is what happens. Canyon comes in. Oh, there's a teleport. I guess Jett just respawns, and that is so unfortunate for him because they're still chasing, and they want to get more. The Chomp comes in. And they're not going to be able to kill the Renekton, but they got everything else.
I mean, this is just domination from Damwon Kia. Once again,
you're Showmaker, you dominate with your team against the lowest team in the LCK in 22 minutes, and then you pick mid Trundle, and you just troll the entire game.
Stomped in this game where you had a pretty cool draft. I mean, you had the Aurelia, you had the Renekton. Plus the Taliyah is Jet is once again dead.
Yeah, he doesn't have his flash. It's like 3 seconds away here, and that's 3 seconds too long.
Don't know if he lives, even if he has it there, but might buy him just enough time. And this is just going to be a Baron play here at 20 minutes.
Yeah. You can see King, and he's doing whatever he can. He's like, I mean, I have to split push. The Rift Herald's in the bottom lane. This is what I have to do. And just one pick into Baron, like, there's nothing he can do. Yeah. Might as well just keep pushing.
Exactly. And that's something that he's kind of been doing this whole game, even in some of those fights he could have teleported into, or the fight at the top side of the jungle where he could have rotated in. And he's like, you guys can try to fight Dom on Kia. I'm good, actually. I'm just going to get money, and maybe we could side lane, and I'm going to help this Rift Herald get a little bit of structure damage. Maybe we can even up some of that gold deficit. And later on, if you guys could just farm through and get some items, we might have a team fight on our hands. Like, I don't want to get too optimistic, but maybe if I could side push enough, if we could side lane, get some structures here, it might one day work out. As Khan will be the one who's targeted.
Okay, can they kill the Ornn? Always a fun question. 4-on-1, and you know, Khan's actually doing a good amount of damage, but they will eventually get him. As DRX, I think they've accepted it as well, trying to go for a little split push. Jet is going to die again, unfortunately.
Yeah, if you were wondering what would have looked like if he had flash moments before, it would have looked something like this.
Yeah.
He no longer has it. That's going to be an inhibitor down. Well, actually,
I mean,
not yet.
You can definitely just stay here. If Ghost comes over, you can absolutely fight this. They just need to worry about King, and as the stun will come in, but you just see him down, and you can see everybody else on the side of DRX is just running away. There's nothing that they can do. Ash has to kite it out. Taliyah has to kite it out. Tahm Kench can't even devour anymore. It's on cooldown.
Ghost just tossing out a flash, you know, just to give him a little bit of just to tell him how he's feeling.
Sure.
Just trying to get into their heads a little bit.
Yep.
That's going to be double inhib.
Not actually going to end the game.
Can't end yet. I mean, we're 22 minutes in, believe it or not. It doesn't feel like it.
But, you know, they still have 25 seconds left on the Baron. And, oh, man, look at the pillar. Piosik's almost dead, and Canyon's going to pick it up.
Did you say almost, Valdez?
Yeah, I misspoke. I'm sorry. Here we go. We're getting in now onto June, who's like, maybe I can go under the ground. Well, you're going to just go down instead. And they're just going to go ahead and push in. This has not been a very competitive series. And Dom1 come in with a statement in this one as Kingan says, wait, no, not the vase.
I'm ready to fight now. Now I'll fight with you guys. I'll fight with my team now.
Oh, no. Oh, what was I? Oh.
Kingan is definitely the one who's like, I am just done with this series.
Look at him. He's getting in there. Yeah, well.
He was not going to fight with his team earlier. He was just going to push and CS.
Showmaker, come on. They've already suffered enough.
Nexus.
They've already suffered enough. Of course, he gets the little dance in before the end. And,
right.
Yep, that was the series, guys. 2-0. Dom1 is going to get it.
You are my winner.